Hey, what's up everyone? Welcome to this new video where I'm going to show you how to write your first API call in Swift. So let's get started. We're going to use an API called the Movie Database, which provides data about movies and TV shows. More specifically, we'll be using this API to retrieve a list of movies. The data we'll receive will be in the form of a JSON payload that looks like this. So first, we need to implement a model that we will use to decode and store the data returned by the API. Luckily, it's going to be pretty easy. We simply need to implement two structs that match the structure of the JSON payload and make sure these structs implement the protocol decodable. That's all we need to do because the compiler will take care of automatically synthesizing the rest of the deserialization code. Next, we need to write the actual network call. We begin by declaring a function that will contain the code of the network call. Then we create the URL of the API endpoint we want to query. You can notice that this endpoint expects one argument, which is an API key. To keep things simple, I'm using string interpolation to inject the API key in the URL. Now, to make the actual network call, we're going to use URLSession, which is Swift's built-in tool for networking. I'm using URLSession.shared, which is a singleton that's already pre-configured, and I call the method data_from_url. Since this method is asynchronous and can throw an error, I'll need to annotate the call site with the keywords try and await. I'll also need to update the signature of my function fetchMoviesFromAPI to indicate that it can now also throw errors and call async code. Then I'll need to use the result of the method dataFromURL. This method returns a tuple that contains two elements, the data payload returned by the API, and some metadata about the response. Here, I'm only interested in the data itself, so I will ignore the second element of the tuple. Finally, we need to decode the data. For this, we're going to use a JSON decoder. I'm going to create a JSON decoder, call its method decodeTypeFromData, and pass as arguments the type of my data model and the actual data I got from the API. Since the decoding process can also generate an error, I need to mark this call with the keyword try. And now all that's left to do is to simply return the array of movies that's been decoded from the result of the API call. That's it, we've written our first API call in Swift. If we want, we can give it a try and print the array of movies to the console to make sure that our code is indeed working as expected. That's all for this video. I hope you've enjoyed this new format. Remember to subscribe to the channel, it's really a big help for me. Thank you for watching and see you next time.